नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, तानिया दीदी हियर. सो वी हैव लर्न द बेसिक ऑफ डेसिमल नंबर. इट इज़ टाइम टू अंडरस्टैंड द मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ अ डेसिमल नंबर. हाउ डू यू मल्टीप्लाई अ डेसिमल नंबर्स? नाउ हियर इन द लास्ट सेक्शन वी डिस्कस्ड अ सर्टेन पॉइंट वेयर वी एड एंड सब्ट्रैक्ट द डेसिमल नंबर एंड वी हैव डन सम प्रॉब्लम ऑल्सो. व्हाट प्रॉब्लम्स ऑल्सो? So now this section we will deal with the multiplication of a decimal number. So when we talk about the multiplication of a decimal number, where do you think that you need to multiply a decimal number? So suppose you went to a shop and there you find that the rate of apples are 2.2 per kg. That is, cost of 1 kg apples is rupees 2.2. Now you choose some apples and when you weight of apples, weight it in the machine, you find that the amount of apples that you are buying is 0.5 kg. So how much price you will have to pay for these many apples? Suppose so basically the price of or cost of 1 kilo apple is rupees 2.2. What would be the price of 0.5 kg? It would be 2.2 × 0.5, right? So this is a place where you need to multiply a decimal number, and how do you multiply that also we should know. In order to understand this, I will take a very simple decimal numbers. Let us try to understand what do you mean by 0.1 × 0.1. Now the meaning it pretty simple. It basically means what is 0.1? It is nothing but it is 1/10. So 1/10 of 1/10. This is the meaning of 0.1 × 0.1. Now suppose you have a train. Suppose this is a train and you have a train with 10 compartments. And so one compartment out of those 10 compartments, that is, it is a 1/10. This concept you know from the fraction chapter, right? Fraction I have told you. From the 10 compartment is one compartment is colored, that means it is a 1/10. Similarly, from the 10 compartment it is a one compartment, that means it is a 1/10. Now, so red color region signify 1/10. Now when I say 1/10 of 1/10, that means I'm talking about 1/10 of red color. So what should be 1/10 of this part? So for that you will have to divide 10 compartment and then one part out of those 10 part. So the these black colors, so this is 1/10. From 1/10 you have to choose 1/10. This is the 1/10 basically. So from 1/10 you have to take again 1/10. So from this region only this black color is 1/10. Clear? So the black color represent 1/10 of 1/10. This black color represent 1/10 of 1/10, right? Because this entire part is 1/10. This red color entire part is 1/10. So basically if I want to understand how much is the 1/10 of 1/10 of the complete part, what fraction of this complete set in this black line, so that is what is the product of this. So for that what we have to do, we have to assume that, let's say that the entire set has been divided into 10 thin compartment, understood? So these 10 compartment divided into 10 thin compartment, okay? And so first compartment has a 10 sub compartment. Again second, similarly second compartment has 10 sub compartment. Again 10 sub compartment, 10 10 10, here also 10. So like this Everywhere you have a 10 sub compartment. So in how many cases you have 10 compartment? So we have seen that 10 cases you have a 10 compartment, right? So 10 cases you have a 10 compartment in bigger 10 compartment. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right? So that means the total how many compartment do you have seen? This is 100, total 100 such compartment, right? It was 10 compartment, from that compartment one colored. It is this part only 1/10. From 1/10 I have colored again 1/10, and with this part I have divided 10 such part, right? So total is 100 part. Total is how much? Total is 100 part. So this is 1/10 of 1/10 is basically this part is now 1/100. Understood the concept? This is 1/10. This black color is 1/10 of 1/10. Now this black color is 1/100, because total is 100. From the 100 parts, this one colored one part is colored. That means 1/100. Understood? So it will be 1/100, and 1/100 is 0.01. Here also one technique is there. We will do the details in next video. Now I am telling the that short way. Now the technique, you just remember, you just normally multiply the, don't forget about the decimal sign, okay? So numerator 1 and 1, so it will be 1 into 1, answer will be 1, right? Answer will be 1. So how we have to put the decimal point? Here you see, after decimal point only one number is there. After decimal point one digit, here also after decimal one digit there. So that is, you have after decimal one, after decimal again one digit. So 1 1 you have the 2 digit, right? So after the decimal, considering both the numbers, so here you place the decimal in such a way that you have 2 digit number after the decimal point. 1 digit 2 digit, so it will be 2 digit. Here already 1 digit is there, so you cannot put 0 here, because I have told you earlier also 10 and 0 1. If I'll write 10 and if I'll write 0 1, so 0 1 is nothing but it is 1 only, but 10 is not a 1. There's a huge difference between 10 and 1, right? There's a huge difference. So you have to, here already 1 digit is there, you have to add another digit. So here you have to put 0. Now 2 digit, then you have to put, before that you have to put decimal. So answer will be 0.01. So that technique details we will see in my second video, next video. So thank you, hope you have understood the concept.